Margaret Jo McCullen.
And I'm Terry Rialto.
And you're listening to
The Delicious Dish on National Public Radio.
Can you believe it, Terry? After a long, hot summer, it's finally turtleneck time again.
That's right, Margaret Jo. We sure love autumn because it's our favorite time of year to cook.
So grab onto your safety bar, because it's going to be a real culinary roller coaster today. As we discuss
squash.
Now, Terry, we've made a real jump start on today's show because we've just returned from Loup City, Nebraska, and the American Gourd Growers Festival.
It was a riot.
11 straight days of gourds.
It was really a fun time.
It was really a blast, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was neat.
It was neat.
It was really fun.
It was fun.
I loved it.
It was good times.
Good times. Yeah. Now, Terry, we have a treat for our listeners today because I just stopped by the photo mat and picked up our photos from the trip.
Oh, great. This will be exciting.
Let's have a look. Okay. We got a kick out. Oh, ooh, we look at that.
That's I remember
neat.
Him.
Oh, that's neat. It's really neat.
Oh, look at that one.
Oh, I love that. What a kick.
Yeah, that was a crazy time.
That's great. Oh,
you look really pretty in that picture.
Oh, I really like that vest.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Oh, that was fun. That was really fun. Glad we did that.
That was neat.
That was really neat. Yeah.
It was fun.
Anyway, today we have a very special guest. He's a controversial figure in the world of squash.
We're talking, of course, about Cameron Ross, author of a book that has turned the gourd community upside down.
Acorn Squash, Life Cycle and Planting Season. Can you tell Terry and I are fans?
Please welcome Cameron Ross. Hi, Cameron.
Hi, Cameron. Let's go ahead.
Hi.
Sit there.
Ooh. Thanks for taking the risk to have me here today.
Oh, it's an honor.
It really is. It's really neat.
Yeah, it's
neat. A great honor. Thanks a lot for being
it's
here.
It's good.
It's fun.
It's
going to
be a good time.
Thank you. Now, Cameron, needless to say, Terry and I are real squash aficionados, but you literally wrote the book on the subject.
It's 7 of them, actually. Plus a book of squash-inspired haikus.
I know. Margaret Jo gave me a leather-bound set for my birthday.
Now, Cam, your earth-shattering theories have changed the way we think about squash.
Yes. For example, I believe the squash growing season could be extended into the first week of November.
Oh, my goodness.
We could get into a lot of trouble for this show. I hope the censors aren't listening.
I am here to rattle your cage. I mean, did you know that the name squash comes from the Native American word akuta squash?
Bless you.
That's funny, but seriously, it's true.
Now, Cameron, since you are the czar of squash factoids, Margaret Jo and I have put together a little quiz for you.
Oh, I will bring it on. Life's an adventure.
Okay. The first question is, what Native American word does the name squash come from? Whoops, actually, I just realized that you just told us that.
Yes, it's akuta squash.
Shoot, we should have written more questions. Hey, look, we have a call.
Delicious Dish.
Delicious Dish,
you're on the air.
Yeah, hi, I'm a big fan of the show.
Oh, thanks.
And with today's topic, I couldn't pass up the opportunity to share a good joke.
Okay, lay it on us.
Okay, I was just thinking that people who don't like squash must be out of their gourd.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I really wanted to call earlier, but I was laughing too hard.
Well, thank you for calling.
Thanks for calling.
You're welcome.
Boy, that sure was a good joke.
I know, I'm going to write it down for days when I'm feeling blue.
I didn't get it.
Oh, really? Well, we were talking about squash, and he said it was making him go out of his gourd. And squash is, in fact, a gourd.
Oh. That would make a really good Far Side.
I was thinking the exact same thing, except for me it was Garfield.
Well, that's all the time we have today. But be sure to join us next week for a fabulous thrill ride when we explore the wonderful world of...
Buns. Oh, I can't believe we just said that.
Anyway, that was a really fun show.
Out of my gourd. That's too much.
It sure is. I haven't laughed that hard since Loop City.